So this middle plan should be positioned on the right of our page. How can we do this? How can we achieve this? Now, with text align right, we can't do it because that's no inline element. If we turn it into one, then we will probably mess up the other styles. Inline block also doesn't look that promising. What we can do is a so-called float. We haven't had a look at floats yet because it's a feature which you don't use that often. You used it a lot in the past to lay out pages, but thankfully these times are over because you introduced a lot of problems with such floats. Now we got better ways like Flexbox, which we'll dive into in this course. But they can be useful. Floating elements can be useful to position some elements differently in your document flow. But what does float mean to begin with? Float means that you override the default positioning and tell the browser to push an element to the left or the right of the page. Not left is actually already the case, but with float you can also, and that will automatically happen, take it out of the document flow. This is also why we're not using floats that often, because you rarely want this. Let me show you how it works. If I add a float to my free plan, so if I go down to my free selector here, we add it by adding the float property and then adding right as a value to float this to the right. If I now reload, you see it's moved to the right and the bottom element takes its place. Now I said that it's taken out of the document flow. As you can see, this is not entirely correct. The text now floats around this element. And that's the idea behind float. It's great for positioning an image in text and make sure that the text actually flows around the image. It's not as great for positioning block level elements as we do, because the text will respond to it, the other block level elements won't, so to say. So that's why we end up with this layout. What we have to do is we have to basically keep its space reserved and tell the other block level elements that come after it that they shouldn't respect any previous floatings. And we do this with a little hack, and that's why you don't really use floats for positioning anymore. It's ugly. You add an additional helper div after the element you floated, so after the free plan section here, a div which you simply give a class with any name of your choice. I'll name it clearFix because I will fix the floating with something which is called clear. And then you define that class. I'll define it before I add my hashtags, my ID selectors, clearFix. And in there, you have one property, clearBoth, which means clear floats on both sides, left and right, which are the two values you can assign here. This means any elements coming after this element or an element with that class will not respect previous floats. So with that, if we save that and reload, you see we're back to the old layout and every element stays in position. Now this is a hacky way of doing that. We got better ways nowadays. We can use different things like Flexbox, which make positioning so much easier and cleaner, and we will dive into that, as I said. But be aware that float is available, that it's great for positioning something like images in text where you want the content to float around or to flow around. But if you want to use it for positioning elements on your page layout, try to avoid it. If you do it, be aware of the clear fix, which actually clears the float to keep the other elements in their place. Now with that, we added the float. Now one thing I also want to do is, the styling here is wrong. The border should now be removed on the right, not on the left. So what I'll actually do is, here on the free selector, I'll add border right and set this to none, and instead add border left, and set this to the same settings I used up there for package in general, 4 pixel solid and that dark green color. That is what I want to add here as my border left. Finally, I also want to move the text to the right with text align right. If we save that and we now reload, the entire plan is pushed to the right. One thing you can see though, the left border does not turn red if we hover over this element. Now, do you know why that is really tricky? And you score bonus points if you know why that's happening. We'll fix it, or we'll talk about it in the next lecture.